nations, which is called as misbranded, adulterated, and spurious drugs. Okay, so coming to misbranded drugs. Okay, now what is branding basically? Have you seen the brands like Adidas, Coca-Cola, and other things? So what is a brand basically? What is the significance of having a brand? Why do people want to have a brand and they don't want to sell anything like that? Just like if they want to sell detergent powder, they won't say it is a detergent powder. They would say that they will give it a name like Surf, Excel, or Ghadi detergent, or Nirma, whatever it is.
Nirma.
Okay.
So brand gives a specific recognition.
Yes, it gives a specific recognition.
Quality, sir. Quality.
To have a standard of the composition.
Product prepared by a particular company.
It does not exactly specify the standard. Okay. Like you can say that X brand of detergent is not good. So that does not specify that this brand means quality. Brand basically would mean a distinct recognition. Okay. So branding is a distinct recognition. Okay. So you can say that this product is not good, but it's very much cheap. So it's value for money. So that is the distinction, that this particular thing is the value for money. The other thing you can say that this is very got a good fragrance. So this brand has got a good fragrance. It comes in all different flavors or different fragrances. Okay. So when you say misbranded drugs, so basically what is hampering is the branding of the drug is being hampered. What is being hampered? The branding of the drug, not nothing else, just the branding. So if you want to affect the branding of a particular thing, what will you do? If a drug is not colored, coated, powder, or polished such that the damage is concealed. Okay. Or if it is made to appear of a better or a greater therapeutic value than it really is. So misbranding is, it was of an inferior quality. So what did you do? You colored it, you coated it, you powdered, or you polished the particular thing so as to hide the damage. Okay. So what damage hide karna chaha aapne? Kyun hide karna chaha? Because you wanted to make it appear as a good brand. Okay. Or if it is made to appear of a better or a greater therapeutic value than it really is. So if you are saying, or if you are portraying it in any way by advertising, labeling, or in any way, if you want to say that my product is better than other products, then it is called as misbranded drugs. Or basically, if it has got X value and you are saying your brand has got 2X value, then it is called as misbranded drug. Okay. If it is not labeled in the prescribed manner, so there is a manner in which it is to be labeled, and if you are not labeling it in the manner, so either you are putting it more content into it, or you are altering the content in such a way that people are not able to identify the things properly. Okay, the side effects or the use or other things. So if it is if you're tampering with the label requirements, if you're tampering with the look and feel of the product, okay, first, second, and third, if the label or a container or anything accompanying the drug bears any statement, design, or device which makes any false claim for a drug or which is false or misleading in any particular way, okay, so then it would lead to a misbranding of a drug. Okay. So how do you misbrand a drug? How do you enhance the value of a particular product? It is by coloring, coating, powdering, or polishing so as to conceal the damage or to make it appear of a higher therapeutic value. Not labeling it properly, or if there's a label or putting something on the label or the container which accompanies the drug to bear any statement. So you can put a statement, good for heart, okay, lowers, cures diabetes or something like that, okay. So if you put a statement over there, or if you make a design. Now suppose if you put a simple or a Horlicks powder, okay, or something kind of a thing, and suppose it's a drug, it's a drug for boosting the immunity or something, and you put a picture of a pehlwan over there, showing his muscles and everything, and you put it, make a container of this design, okay, and you put the product into it. So the first impression that the people will get is there's a bodybuilder on the device. So if I have this particular powder, I will also become a bodybuilder kind of a person. So this kind of a thing will lead to design misbranding or device, you know, anything which makes a false claim for the drug, which is false or misleading. So there are three definitions. There will be three definitions. One is misbranded drugs, other will be adulterated, and the third would be spurious. So remember that when you are studying misbranded drugs, you need to know it's basically hampering or altering the branding or the uniqueness of that particular product. Now coming to the second thing, which is called as an adulterated drug. So adulterated drug basically is nothing, but it's basically addition of something. What you're doing is, you can just remember it very easily, like AD is for addition, AD is for adulteration. Okay. So whenever you are adding something into it, it is called as adulterated drugs. Okay. Now for this purpose, there can be addition. Addition can be from outside. It can be knowingly, it can be unknowingly. So whatever it is, both the things, by either you add it knowingly, or if that addition comes unknowingly into the product, that is also called as adulterated drug. Okay. Now we see the various components of this definition. If it consists in whole or in part of any filthy, that is dirty or that is not recommended, okay, filthy, putrid, again very thing, or a decomposed substance. So if your drug is containing anything which is filthy, which is dirty, which is organic or inorganic or organic impurities, or which has got decomposed substances. Now this decomposition can happen naturally because your product got contaminated with certain microorganisms and it got degraded. Okay. So it consists of a filthy, putrid, decomposed substance, or if it has been prepared, packed or stored under insanitary conditions. So the conditions were not proper and it got contaminated, whereby it may have been contaminated. So you're not saying that it has been contaminated. They are saying it may have been contaminated with a filth or whereby it may have been rendered injurious to the health. That is also called as adulterated drug. So there's nothing intentionally done, but the packaging, storing and preparation were under insanitary conditions, because of which this filth came into the product. Thirdly, if the container is composed in whole or in part of any poisonous or deleterious substances. So you had the best intentions, you made the product very nicely and everything, but the container that you were using released or had some poisonous or deleterious substances, which may render the contents injurious to health. So from the container, say lead came out from the container, or glass particles broke out and came into the product. Okay. So these things will make the product injurious to the health. They will be called as adulterated. If it bears or contains, for purposes of coloring, only a color other than which one is prescribed. So if you are using a color other than the one which is prescribed, it is again called as adulterated. So you wanted to have, you are adding, say, a light orange color to it. With the addition of light orange color, your product should become dark red. Okay. Now suppose for some reason your product is not becoming that dark red, and instead of orange color, you are using a red color to make it more red, then it is an addition of some other substance. Okay. So in this condition also, it will be called as adulterated. If it contains any harmful or toxic substance which may render it injurious to the health, then also it is called as adulterated. And if any substance has been mixed therewith so as to reduce its quality or strength, then also it is called as adulterated. So you are adding it something from outside, it contains some harmful or toxic substance, it contains colors which are not prescribed, it is the container is helping in degradation or producing deleterious substances, it is packed under insanitary conditions, thereby adding filth into the substance, or whole or part of it has got filth or putrid or decomposed substance. Okay, then it is called as an adulterated substance. So we see that misbranding is about hampering the brand or the uniqueness of the product by altering the color coating, making it appear higher quality, labeling not labeling in a prescribed manner, or the label contains statement, design or device which makes false claims. Adulteration is adding something. So there are six subpoints in it. Misbranded had three subpoints in it. And now coming to spurious drugs. Now, what is the meaning of spurious? Students, can you tell me the meaning of spurious? Students?
So false.
False, yes. False or something fake. That is called as spurious drugs. So when does it become spurious? When does it become fake? So either you are altering with a drug. Okay. You had to put drug A and you had to put drug B. So it becomes spurious because you are putting something fake into it. Okay. The second thing is it has to be supplied by a company A, but a company B is supplying it, putting the label of company A. So if you are altering the manufacturer, or you are altering the drug, in both these cases it becomes spurious. So what are the two things? One is altering the name, altering the drug in by itself, or altering the manufacturer. Okay, so number one, if it is imported under a name which belongs to another drug, so you change the manufacturer, the drug was same, or you change the name of the drug. So there was a costly drug, importing it in India was difficult or it was costly, so you change the name of the drug to a lower, a cheaper drug, and you import, you try to import that drug into the country, okay, with another name. So it is a fake thing, it's a wrong thing. Okay, if it is an intimation or a substitute of another drug, so you are, what you have done, you have made a copy of it, you are doing intimations, again that is fake or that is wrong. For another drug or resembles another drug in a manner likely to deceive or bears upon it or upon its label or container the name of another drug, unless it is plainly and conspicuously marked so as to reveal the true character and its lack of identity with such other drugs. So if there are two or more drugs in the market, and if you are using an intimation or a substitute of another drug, or even if it resembles another drug. Okay, so if there are two different companies and both of them are keeping their brand names almost same, okay, then also it will be called as a spurious drug. So A company is making something, B company made another drug which resembles that particular thing, and then it is called as a spurious drug. If the label of the container bears the name of an individual or a company purporting to be manufacturer of the drug. So there is a company which is saying that I am the manufacturer, while actually they are not the manufacturer. So in that case also it is called as a spurious drug. So it could be an individual or a company which is fictitious or a fiction or not existent. If it has been substituted wholly or in part by another drug or substance. So if you are adding, changing something, then also it will be called as a spurious drug. If it purports to be a product of a manufacturer of whom it is not a truly a product. So by changing the name of the manufacturer, changing the name, changing the drug in itself, or adding some substitute into it, these things will be called as spurious drugs. Okay. So,
any doubts? Can't it be called adulteration?
No, it will not be called it adulteration because it has been substituted wholly or partly by another drug or substance. Okay, so there are some conflicting overlaps also between definitions. Okay, but here it is substituted wholly in part. Okay, without the intention of making any filth or harmful into it. But when you adulterate it something, okay, So when you're iterating it in all the definitions, you will see that there is something decomposed, okay, injurious, okay, coloring change, harmful, okay, to reduce the quality. Okay, so this is called as unadulterated, and that is called as spurious. What we will do in the next